This followed a finding by the Auditor General, John Mwanga, who noted that between July 2022 to 3rd March 2023, a total of 7,839.1 kilograms of processed gold were exported, from which the government expected to collect export levy amounting to 5.811 billion shillings. However, only 428,703,625 shillings was collected by Uganda Revenue Authority, leaving a balance of 5.383 billion shillings outstanding.
We are not levying revenues on gold.
Irene Batebe, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development, informed the committee that the outstanding export levy amounting to 3.178 billion shillings was due from three gold exporters who obtained a court order that halted collection of export levy on gold, while the balance of 2.24 billion shillings was due from an exporter who had made a party payment for their total levies.
Three gold exporters, that's Bullion, Onish and Metal, they obtained a court order in early April that halted collection of the export levy. So we've been dealing with a court order, but also the policy directive, and that's why it is important that Cabinet really has a final position on the issue of levying of gold.
Mwanga Chivumbi, the chairperson of the Parliament's Public Accounts Committee, tasked the ministry to furnish Parliament with the names of the directors and companies that are defaulting and failing to pay taxes.
Out of seven, you have talked one has paid, three are in court. What about the three?
To be precise, mention the companies that are defaulting and failing to pay and put them on record.
Maybe we would need to ask the accounting officer to tell us why she's telling us new things now, which she did not tell the Auditor General, who had a lot of time for us. We have just a few hours.
Members of Parliament asked the ministry to explain what steps government has undertaken to deal with the court order that was sought by gold exporters to stop this tax.
What has the Attorney General done to date in maybe seeing to it that this court order is either vacated or whatever? What has the Attorney General done?
We are a country losing revenue, and good people, both in the ministry and the Attorney General, are not making any effort to either appeal or recede that action.
Batebe informed the committee that the Attorney General Chidiowa Chiwanuka appealed against that court order, and the application for the temporary injunction was dismissed by court, a revelation that angered members of Parliament, tasking the ministry to explain what is then stopping government to demand the gold exporters to pay their share of taxes.
Court had the application for that temporary injunction and dismissed it. But again, like we said, that consultation with Cabinet is what will then give us the final...
What are we hearing? Even before the court order, there was no action. Even when the court order was done out with, no action.
The ministry also attributed the delays to collect gold tax on a presidential directive issued during a cabinet meeting, but when asked to provide evidence to back those claims, Batebe failed to furnish any evidence to the committee.
Even under the constitution, the president is the minister of finance, who can use that provision to summon the president to appear before this committee.
Madam, you are causing a loss to government. Who is the officer responsible in this department? You are just ahead.
Like I indicated, the collection is done by URA. We support them.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.